I'm just checking 1 second.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, she's ready.
Yeah, we're live. Hi, everyone. Welcome to another episode of Sapna Rise. I'm Natasha Doshi, and we have someone very special here with us today. We have Miss Megha Bajaj. She is a very acclaimed author. She has won so many awards for her books, Thank You Cancer, I Inspire, and Happiness, and In the Age of Ambition. And she's been writing scripts for so many movies. She's also worked with popular production houses. So welcome to Sapna Rise, Megha.
Thank you so much, Natasha. Such a pleasure to be here. And I must say that I've visited the Sapna bookstores, you know, and very, very long back when I was in Bangalore. And it literally feels like home. It's not like a bookstore. It feels like a space where you just want to sit, you want to read. Everybody's friendly. And no wonder you guys call yourself one of the largest, you know, stores. And there's a beautiful feeling. So thank you so much. And thank you for having me here.
That's really sweet of you. In fact, all of our founder members also will be so happy to hear this coming from you.
Thank you so much.
Megha, we're here today to discuss your book, The Breakthrough. And must say, I have personally read the book and it's so fresh, so inspiring. And I honestly felt very connected to all the stories that you've penned down. So it's very magical.
Thank you so much, Natasha. I just feel so good because, you know, as an author, you keep writing, and then suddenly you don't know how is it going to be received. And hearing it from you, and I know you told me like long back once when we were speaking, you said you're a literature student. So knowing that you come from that background and you liked it so much means that much more. Thank you so much, Natasha.
So tell all our viewers about the book, Megha. I mean, what is this book? How did it happen? What is it about?
So, The Breakthrough is literally that. It's a breakthrough. So from a very young age, Natasha, I've been very fascinated with magic. Okay. And while earlier it began with magic, like, you know, the potions and Harry Potter and that kind of magic, slowly as I grew up, I realized the magic is a lot more about the potential we have within ourselves, how people change their lives, how you can transform what you were to what you are and what you will become, you know. And this magic just fascinates me. It just intrigues me so much. So this book, The Breakthrough, is about 11 people who literally began their life with nothing. Okay. I wouldn't even say nothing in some cases, like literally a minus, you know. They had debts, they had every possible issue that, you know, you could think of. And today, all of them are living lives which are like they're called trailblazers. The globe looks up to them in some cases, you know. The country looks up to them, their people look up to them. And what I love about them is that they're living a life which is not just about rags to riches. That's not just, you know, that's a very small aspect. It's like they've transformed their relationships. They've transformed themselves. They've transformed their health. They've transformed their life, you know, in every aspect. And that magic and how it happened is what The Breakthrough is all about. So it's fascinating because it's all about real life magic. And yeah, that's what the book is about in a nutshell. And the amazing part has been that everybody who's been reading it, Natasha, says that they're experiencing breakthroughs in their life because there's this whole energy of breakthrough that's kind of got created. And everybody, I mean, the people from Kashmir to Germany to I don't know where all, and they've all been saying that it's not just their breakthrough. Reading about them, we feel we are having a breakthrough and we actually have one. So that's been the fascinating part.
It's so beautiful to hear this book, you know, hear about this book from you because your face completely lights up when you're talking about it. And why don't you tell us your relationship with Guru Mahatreya, because that's something that's literally the foundation of the book. So what about, how did you get in touch with him and how did he come to be your guru?
So I mean, I have been a very creative, a very different kind of a child when I was in school. And I don't think I necessarily fit in. And I was you know, I would top 1 year if I wanted to. I would be in the bottom if I didn't want to. I was very whimsical, a little strange, and I always felt like a misfit. Okay, and I'm going to again talk about Harry Potter. Like, I felt like how Harry Potter would have felt with muggles, literally. So very young, I was fortunate enough to meet my Guru Mahatmya, and just in my early 20s. And when I met him, he was speaking all the things that I was thinking in terms of, okay, faith, surrender, magic of life, positive thinking. You can be what you want to be. And he was not just talking it, he was walking it. And watching him, I literally felt, oh, so that world in my inner world that I thought is just somewhere in the mind and doesn't really exist can actually exist. So my relationship with him began with, like, you know, I was too young, so I couldn't understand the profoundness of all that he was. So it began as like a best friend. I felt he's my best friend and I can tell him everything about my life. It grew into like him almost being like a parent to me. Then it grew further. It grew further. And over the years, it's become like I literally feel that he's more real to me than anything else that we so-called call real. Literally, like, I can just close my eyes and I feel he's with me, you know. And that kind of a presence with such an evolved soul, that kind of an ongoing relationship, it inspires and it, you know, literally empowers your life in ways you can't imagine. So every moment has become like magical, all miracles. So much of goodness has been flowing in with this one relationship. And I no longer see him as a relationship. I see him as the relationship. And I think that makes all the difference. So it's been a beautiful journey.
That's so good to hear. And I think it's really inspiring because I've heard a couple of his videos and he sounds so inspiring. And more than anything, whatever he's trying to say is very relatable to us as millennials. And, you know, it's something that we can adapt on a day-to-day life. So I think that's exactly where it...
And, you know, he doesn't talk about things like, oh, I'll give you one thing and your life will change. So he tells you, you want something, you jolly well work hard for it. But here are those things that will make shifts. See, it's like if two people are working hard towards a goal, how is it that still one gets it and one doesn't? That's the magic that he teaches you all about, you know, self-belief, your mind. And it's been, I mean, and you know, when you see practical magic, you think something and then you see it happening. It's amazing. So I must tell you something about Sapna related to this. When the book had just released, it had come, I think, at least for a week or two in the bestseller, you know, it was there. And so often as a young reader, I would come and I would just see that 10, you know, that shelf with the 10 books, bestsellers. Yeah. And I wonder, will there be a day where I'll be there and not reading books from there? So can you imagine that moment when I saw Breakthrough then, one of my friends, Guru Prasad Makkam, who stays in Bangalore, who's also written about in the book, he sent a pic of that, you know, thing happening. And I was like, oh, I just visualized this, but today it's become a reality. So this is the kind of real life magic that I love and that I think all these 11 people live. And my Guru Mahatmya has taught me to believe in it.
Wow. So the book contains 11 stories, different. It's a culmination of different stories. It's a single book with so many experiences put together. So how did this happen? How did you conceptualize the book?
It happened in a light bulb moment, actually. I mean, the whole process, of course, took a lot more time. But so in 2016, Mahatmya had announced a kind of gathering of a lot of people. So there were thousands of seekers from across the globe who came. And he gave awards to about 30 people who he felt were living a very holistic life. You know, and exactly this, like healthy, wealthy, beautiful relationships and spiritually aligned. So a complete 360 degree perspective. And like, you know, he gave us, my family, an award as well. And about 30 people got the award from these thousands. And I was just sitting there and as I was watching these people receive awards, it just struck me that doesn't the world need to know about real people who are living, you know, such real lives, lives that we can relate to, and yet lives which are so aspirational. You know, so this one thought, it just happened. And that moment, I was like, can I write a book about this? But it took me some time to actually get to the process. And being getting to these 11, and they all live in different cities, as luck would have it. So being with them, and I had one clause in, you know, wanting to work with these 11, that I don't want to do an interview over Zoom or call. Or, and luckily it was 2019, so I could actually go and meet them. So I've literally gone, Natasha, and lived with these 11 people. You know, I've seen them like eating breakfast. I've seen them playing with their kids. I've seen them at business. There's one guy called Nitin Nyati. He actually allowed me, he's a builder, and he actually allowed me to attend one of his board meetings. Okay. And the board meeting began with all of them chanting Om. And I was fascinated with what was kind of unfurling in front of me. So it was amazing. I mean, I was literally in airports that entire year, but it was fun and more fun.
It sounds like such an exciting journey to, you know, visit these people, learn so much about it. And in fact, it's penned so beautifully. Personally, as I was saying, when I've read the book, I feel like I know these people, and it's something written about a friend or somebody I really can relate to. It's so relatable, it's fresh, and at the same time, it's something that it's so simple that anybody can understand. You know, I read a couple of your interviews, and you were saying that this book is mainly for students as well. And that kind of language is so easygoing that it's not hard to follow. If you're reading about some ethos, or if you're reading about a thought, I think it takes a little longer for you to understand that if it's coming from a guru. But you've simplified it in such a beautiful way. I think anybody and everybody from all age groups can actually read the book.
Thank you so much. It means so much to me. Really means a lot.
Yeah. The book, in fact, is so visual, because if you see, I mean, there are so many different colors that you've used. Each chapter is colored. So that kind of enhances your visual appeal also in terms of reading each chapter.
And each color represents the personality. So it was awesome fun. Like, we have a WhatsApp group among the 11 of us and me, and they were all fighting for the colors. You know, these are like such awesome people, and like little children, they're like, I want orange. No, you took away green. And okay, you take it. Don't worry. So it was very cute. And each color represents that personality, you know. So it's there's a lot of thought that's gone behind creating this book.
I actually didn't know that, but that's something really deep that you've actually put in into the book.
Thank you so much.
And why did the name happen, like the breakthrough? So what was your thought behind the name of the book?
So I wanted to have a very powerful name, and the breakthrough basically means a very drastic, sudden change. Okay. And usually it just stops there. But for me, it meant like a change in your thought process, where you, before that breakthrough and you after that breakthrough, though you look the same, everything's the same, but you know everything's changed forever. And I'm sure like the viewers who are watching this can relate that they've all had those moments of breakthroughs where everything changes forever. So I wanted to kind of highlight that all these 11 people, what sets them really apart is that they've had a series of breakthroughs, and they've had that ability to see an incident, create it into a breakthrough, and ensure that it changes their life forever. You know, so it just felt most fitting to have it called the breakthrough. And Mahathir's like tagline for Infinityism is inspiring breakthroughs. So I kind of felt that, you know, he's inspiring breakthroughs, and these people are the breakthroughs. So why not kind of, it just made a lot of logical sense to me.
Yeah, absolutely. And in fact, the story I could relate to the most is Guru's story, because, you know, about school life, about bullying, and the way he's evolved and, you know, emerged, and he founded the company. So I felt like that was the most beautiful and inspiring story for me.
Such a notorious one. I mean, there are people who told me that they laugh reading it, they cry reading it, and then they're like, oh my God, he's gone on to build one of the top 20 CA firms in India, which is some phenomenal journey.
Absolutely. Yeah. So what was your breakthrough in life?
Okay. I think my biggest breakthrough, especially related to this book, was So we were ready with the book sometime in May, okay, May 2020. And we were like, okay, the book's ready now. What do we do? How do we kind of launch it? Because they're all in separate cities, complete lockdown, pandemic, horrible. Everyone's like at the worst thing. And I felt that it's at this time that people need this book more. So I didn't want to wait because I felt that a breakthrough is exactly what the world is looking for. And why would I not want to launch it? So we decided to do a virtual launch. And because 11 of them were there, and I had this amazing two people called Amar and Sridhar join the entire thing, and they were helping me with things. So we were like, if we have to do a digital virtual launch, let's make it the world's biggest launch. Okay, that was the thinking. And we were like, okay, so we spoke to some people. What are the numbers? They were like, okay, we know of somebody who's done like a 1 lakh people attended it. So we were like, okay, let's make sure that ours is attended by 111. So 111,111. That was our dream. And we wanted to launch it on 15th August. So we did so many things, and like Book My Show became a partner. We partnered with so many people. Amazing things happened. And that was another breakthrough. I realized that when your vision expands, like typically in a book launch, you know, be working with Sapna, I'm sure you know that 100, 200 people will physically attend it. So I had always had book launches with 200 people attending it, and suddenly 111, which is like into NX, right? Like it looked too big. And we didn't know how it's going to happen. I mean, even if you invite all your friends, it's still not going to be that much between the 11 of us, right? 11 plus me. So we did a lot of things. And somehow on 14th August, okay, night, we had 23,000 registrations. So we were very excited. We were like, okay, that's pretty cool. It's a good number. I mean, whatever. But obviously inside there was this feeling that 111 should have happened. I remember this moment. It was such a profound moment, Natasha. I was like, we always hear this quote, right? You do your best and then you leave the rest. I genuinely felt I had done my best. Like I had done everything I could. So I was like, okay. I remember sleeping and just praying and being like, dear God, universe, Mahatriya, whatever it is, I have done what I could. Now you take over. And literally with that thought, I was like, okay, now surrender, just enjoy the whole process and have fun with the book launch. And the whole book launch happened, everything happened. And later we got to know that, so we wanted 111 people to attend. Can you guess how many people attended it?
Hard to actually take a guess with the numbers you just gave me. I'm sure it reached more than that.
Yeah, so we had 500,000 people, close to. We had 382,500 live clicks. So it was like, literally, I mean, and I have no explanation for this even now, Natasha, because we had registrations and we had 23,000 by 14th night. 12 o'clock is when I last checked.
Yeah.
And I don't know what happened. So maybe a lot of people got the invites but just didn't register but ended up coming. So to me, that was the biggest breakthrough, because that was exactly what we're trying to tell through the book, that the power of your mind, the power of, you know, doing the right things, the power of giving it your all. And I love that moment where it was like, I gave everything. You know, it's like in that quote, it says, you give your best, comma, then God does the rest. Yeah. That comma is so beautiful for me, because in that comma is when that humility comes in, that, okay, I've done what I could. Now you take over. And what magic happens is, it's literally like, as I'm talking, I'm getting goosebumps, you know? So that's how, I think that was the biggest breakthrough, that to get a book out like this itself was a breakthrough, and to do it in the pandemic with that kind of viewership was another huge breakthrough.
Wow. This is so pure, actually, you know, this story that you just narrated, it's really inspiring. At the same time, there's so much genuineness to it. So I mean, I'm speechless after hearing the numbers, especially.
Yeah, it leaves you feeling very humble. You know, it really makes you feel that, yeah, you feel that I did. But it's in that I did and then I let go that actually the universe responds. So It was phenomenal.
I'm so glad you had this experience.
I'm so glad too. It's one of my those, you know, like we keep reliving moments which are really special to us. And this is one of those for me for sure.
Absolutely. How did you pick these 11 stories? You know, because I'm sure you've had so many experiences and encounters of meeting people who've experienced such situations. But why did you pick these 11 characters?
I had heard of a few of them, like through my guru, and I knew a few of them personally as well. And I had watched them. I was very clear. I wanted to write about people who are not just talking, but walking their talk. Because, you know, it's like this book should make them feel even more like responsible towards doing more. Right? It shouldn't be like, oh yeah, we have arrived. So I knew a few of them, like Sushil Mehta, Arun Kumar Natha, some of these people, Guru. I knew of them and I had heard from people about them that they're very inspiring. They're doing phenomenal things, you know. So I already knew of them. That made it easier to connect to them and kind of be with them. But I had a complete process. Like, I didn't want to choose anyone basis my likes, my wants, my... So I had a huge interview process, okay? And it was fun because, like, I'm the youngest of the lot, okay, of these 11. And I'm going and interviewing them to check if they can be a part of my book, you know? And they are, like, literally, like, little school boys answering, school boys and school girls. And one of them is an educator, Chitra Prasad. And like a little girl, she answered everything, told me. So I literally evaluated them on health, wealth, their relationships, their peace of mind. Like an MCQ, I spoke to them. And when I spoke, I could feel that, no, these are the people I want to, you know, work with. These are the people I want to write about. And just the word you said, purity and genuinity, it came through from these 11 for me, and which is why I got these 11.
It must have been really hard to do so much research and kind of put everything together.
You know, a lot of people ask me that hard and challenge, but I think when you're loving something, even if it's hard, it doesn't feel hard. Like, it's a book that's got so much content and, you know, it took me so much time. See, I'll tell you, I'll explain to you. It's such a beautiful thing. Like, 11 people, each of them are, first, they're all telling me, we'll be done in 2 hours. We don't have much to speak. Each of them spoke for 11 hours. Okay? So 11 into 11 hours. After that, I had to sit and transcript that. So that, like, just transcribing what they spoke took like so many days and it was huge. Okay? So it translated into about 111 pages each. Out of that, I had to choose what parts I want to retain for the story, how I want to go. Then I began writing the story. Then I edited the story. Then I sent it to them. Then they had, you know, factual corrections to make. So you can imagine the whole thing. But I don't know what it was, Natasha. I loved it so much that there were days where my eyes were swollen red. And like, literally my, you know, my friends, everyone's like, please go to sleep. What are you doing? You know, and my fingers were swollen. But I couldn't stop writing. It was a flow. So I think because I enjoyed the process so much, it never felt hard or challenging. I'm just loving it. It's like that.
It actually reflects in the book. When you actually sit down to read the book, everything that you're talking about, it's so neat. It's so crisp. At the same time, I love the indexing of each chapter. You've written tax. You've written the word tax one, tax two, tax three. It's very beautifully written.
Thank you, you know,
the best part is I think people can pick each chapter whenever at their convenience to read instead of just sitting down and reading the whole book. Since it's segmented so beautifully, you can actually pick just one and read it.
Absolutely. In fact, I would recommend that to the readers that it's not a book that you devour, you know. It's a book like you literally have to sip it like a wine. It's like a few pages, then you ruminate, you kind of, you know, let it brew in you. You realize how it reflects in your life. Then you read a few pages. So it's not a quick read. It's a read that I hope transforms people. Because writing it did so much for me. So I just feel like I hope all that magic kind of goes into the reader and does something for them.
I hope so too. Mm-hmm. Has Guru Maharaj read the book?
So I have sent it to him. This is the first time I ever been asked this question. I've sent it, and I believe some of the other 11 also sent it. So he must be having quite a lot of breakthroughs in his house now. His ways are his ways. I don't know if he's read it. I don't know if he will, you know. But he knows me so well. He knows how I write so well. And I think some, like with evolved souls, I don't think they need to read anything to kind of know it. They just know it. So he just told me one line about the book. And he said that anyone who reads even a single line of this book will feel transformed. And to me, that's, I mean, what more can I hear from someone who I love and admire so much?
Absolutely. Yeah. It's just beautiful to hear that, actually. What was the toughest chapter to write? Because you're writing so many stories. So for you personally, which was the most difficult chapter?
Okay. You're really asking all questions which have not been asked before. And for you viewers, you should know, I've not seen the questions. So she's just shooting them and like we're having fun with this. I think I would say I found writing Kanni and Yuvraj, which is the last story. It's the 11th story. It's about Purvika Mobiles. I'm sure being in Bangalore, you've seen all the Purvikas around you. I found that really tough because it was the other people were one. Like I wrote about one person. Here it's a couple and it's their journey. So I had to literally get Kanni's perspective, Yuvraj's perspective, intertwine them and see where the two perspectives meet to have co-created a brand, a mobile brand like Purvika. So it was amazing because I had to think from two perspectives rather than one. You know, and when they read it and they called me, the best thing Yuvraj told me is that I cried when I read it. And I was like, what else can I ask? You know, he's like, I can't imagine that you understood me more than me. And to me, that was like a profound moment. I felt like the writer in me won that moment because it was really tough to get their chapter out. But yeah. And what a story. I mean, they've begun with a debt of 2 lakhs and today they run 390 plus stores and they are the number one, you know, mobile retail outlet in India. So from where to where, that journey was just amazing.
Yeah. We have a couple of audience comments as well. I want to read them out because they're such nice things. Libini says she loved the book. Then there's Vishnu Priya Raju who says, loving you so much, Megha Bajaj. Nitin Shah says, apt quote. I think he's referring to the one that you spoke about regarding God, you know, leave the rest to God. Then again, Vishnu Priya says, breakthrough book. Shreya Doshi says, it's like a movie. And Balaji says, hi to you.
Oh, wow. Thank you so much. Thank you, guys.
So, Megha, I think even the back blurb, if you see, you've written down some things, you know, some teachings of why people should read this book. So, do you practice this in your real life? And how did you manage to, like, this is like a really neat summary when somebody picks up the book, like, why should you read the book?
So,
do you practice this in your daily life? And what changes have you seen personally?
Natasha, I've really been striving. I mean, there's this thing, right? Buddham Sharanam Gacchami, Dhammam Sharanam Gacchami, and Sangham Sharanam Gacchami. So Buddham Sharanam Gacchami is that be with your master. You know, and in the earlier days, it used to always be like ashram culture, right? Where you actually lived with a master. But that's not possible now. So then they say, okay, do Dhammam Sharanam Gacchami, which is like, you follow the messages of your master and you do follow it, but oftentimes you get a little lost. So the last one is so beautiful because it says Sangham Sharanam Gacchami, which says that when you're surrounded by like-minded and right-minded people, it has a very profound impact on your thinking. I can tell you that writing the breakthrough, okay, and being with these 11 people, like now we're all friends, they're people who I really relate to on a daily basis with most of them. And I can tell you being with them has helped me so much because I don't need to make the mistakes they've made. I don't need to, I can just see them and I can be like, oh, this is what I should do. This is what I don't need to do, you know? So much, I literally feel that this book and these 11 people have paced my growth by at least 10 years, you know, minimum. Because all that I would have had to go through myself, I'm learning from them and I'm like, okay, I'm done, you know? So it's amazing. And you say that, you know, those 11 points or whatever, I keep striving because I see them like that. Like all of them are constantly, you know, energy on the move, enthusiasm on the move. And I watched them through the pandemic. Okay, the book was ready, so nothing to do with the book. But all of them, if I call them during the pandemic, oh, how's things? Oh, business has become more. Things have become more. We've hired 100 more people. I said, like, people are downsizing. People are doing this. What are you all doing, you know? And that's the way they are. So being with them made me, I think it's really made me into an even more go-getter and even more, I want to keep striving. So I'm never going to be perfect. And I, you know, but can I keep striving to be better today than yesterday? Something I've been doing and I hope I'm doing it well. You'll have to ask the people around me.
Actually, Megha, you know, when you are positive as a person, it kind of again reflects in the book. So whatever experiences you've had, as I've been saying, it has reflected a lot in the book. So to everybody watching, please go get the book. It's available across all our Sapna Bookhouse outlets. It's also available online at sapnaonline.com. So please go get your copy, because these 11 stories are real life stories and they're just about transformation with a single thought process. It's not even like a formula that's come through. It's just a simple thought.
Exactly. I mean, yeah. And the average age of a person in this book is 50. So literally it's got 550 years of mistakes, love, learning, sweat, meditation, everything. So why would you want to go through it? Just take it all from them and like pace your life like never before.
Libini has a very interesting question. She says, how do you recognize a breakthrough when it comes your way? Or can you actually recognize one?
So well, Libini, I would say that when you're open to life and when you're kind of, you know, when you're not close to new experiences, when you're open to learning, open to seeing a moment as a breakthrough, you can recognize that, okay, this is where a breakthrough is, you know. I think it takes openness to understand that a breakthrough has happened. And I think what really makes a very big difference is that the incident has happened, but how you process it in your mind once, twice, a million times makes all the difference. So like I told you, if I have to give you a historic example, when Gandhi was thrown on that platform, right? It was just an incident. For someone else, it's not that he was the first Indian to be thrown off. Maybe so many more were thrown where we don't even know about them. It's what went into his mind. Like Mahatma says it so beautifully. It's like, it's not what happens to you. It's what happens through you that makes all the difference. Okay. So what happened through him? And like, I was one seeker among thousands of seekers watching that show, you know, when he was awarding the people. What was that light bulb moment? And what did I process for so many years to have reached this point of creating this book, right, with these 11 people? So I think it's all about taking that incident, processing it in the right direction, in the higher direction, and you get your breakthrough, you know. So I would say, Libini, it's not just that you have a breakthrough, you recognize, I actually think you can create breakthroughs. And that's what this book is all about, because we want people to create breakthroughs, right? It's not about waiting for one to happen to you. And it's all about what goes in between these 2 years.
Libini, I hope that helps you. Megha, who's your inspiration apart from Guru Mahatraya? I've been very curious to ask you that.
I would say life itself, Natasha, because really for me, in every moment I'm feeling like wherever I am, I'm just looking at people as, oh, what is it that I can learn from them? So whether it's an auto rickshaw guy or it's something else, or it's, you know, just a dog on the street. I think when you're open, like, you know, I said about the question as well, like, when you're just open to learning and knowing more, everything ends up being an inspiration. I mean, the sunrise is an inspiration, the sunset is an inspiration, and everything's an inspiration. Like right now, sitting here with you, your patience, your in-depth questions, the way you're smiling continuously is an inspiration, because not everyone can be so genuine about an interview, right? Like, so everything's an inspiration. I don't know. I don't find myself feeling, oh, I'm only inspired by this. I'm just generally inspired all the time.
That's so sweet of you.
Yeah.
Megha, I think it's your connection.
Is it?
Yeah, it's better now.
Okay, great.
You've written about really meaningful topics. You've written about cancer. You've written a book called I Inspire, Happiness in the Age of Ambition, and now The Breakthrough. So you've actually written about quite a few sensitive, at the same time, inspirational topics, something that a reader can take away. So any plans for your coming books? What are you planning to write next?
A lot of crazy stuff is coming. I mean, things are, so like every year, Mahathir gives a year a name, okay? So like he says that it's a theme for the year and he wants all of us to kind of do more of that. So this year, he says the year is CYCZ, challenge your comfort zone. Okay. So I am literally doing that. Like, I'm writing a book. I don't want to give out too much, but I'm writing a book on cricket and I've never watched a game myself. So it's going to be that crazy. And I'm going to challenge myself in directions that are unheard of, because that's what life is all about, right? Like, when I was writing Breakthrough, I thought, oh, this is it. Today, I already feel like, oh, it's time for the next thing. What more? What next? What more? What next? In fact, that's the mantra that Sushil Mehta, one of the people I've written about. His mantra in life is what more? What next? What more? What next? And that has become such a part of me. So every time I'm like, okay, what more? And a lot of books are coming up. I think the one common thread will remain that they're going to be inspiring. They're going to be very happy books. They're going to be very cheerful, because that just who I am, and I can't remove myself from my writing.
Looking forward to the book.
Thank you so much.
Megha, lastly, if you had to summarize The Breakthrough for all our readers in a sentence or two, you know, for all those who have just joined in it and they don't know much about the book, how would you just summarize it?
I would say all of us have all the magic within us to be a lot more than we are, not just in our careers. I think we all can be a lot more healthier, a lot more beautiful as people, a lot more peaceful as people. One thing that I see is that a lot of people have lost peace. You know, we are like running without knowing where we are running. It's almost like we're on a treadmill and it's just, we're walking, but we don't know whether we're going anywhere. So I think we all have the power of creating and attracting breakthroughs within us. And I just hope that this book becomes one more way to help you to get those. And the lives of these 11 are so inspiring. And reading about it, you feel it's you. That's the way I've written it. Like, I don't feel you, reading about Chitra or Dr. Asha will make you feel you are Chitra or Dr. Asha. It won't make you feel like it's someone far removed from you. So that's the whole thing. And I hope you have a life of breakthroughs, because that's what we deserve. And no breakdowns, only breakthroughs.
Wow. To everyone who's listening, please go get your copy. And I honestly hope, Megha, that you have many more breakthroughs and you have many more successes regarding your books. Thank you so much for joining us today and spending so much time with us. It was a beautiful conversation.
Thank you so much, Natasha. And thank you, Sapna Bookstores. Really, you all are like home. And the next time in Bangalore, I'm going to come and visit all of you.
Please. I think next time we should do like a proper offline book launch.
Would love that. Would love that. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Megha. It was lovely talking to you.
You too. Absolutely a pleasure, Natasha.
Thank you.
Bye.